चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट ऑफ मोमेंट्स द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड. A child goes to a fair with his parents. He is happy and excited and wants the sweets and toys displayed there. But his parents don't buy them for him. Why then does he refuse when someone else offers them to him? It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerge a gaily clad humanity. Means wintry means cold, narrow lanes and alleys means dark and very narrow lanes. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat, being carried in bamboo and bullock carts. One little boy ran between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. So, in the first paragraph, the vivid description of the festival is given, that the festival of spring was a gay occasion and it was held in a village. A number of people were going to the fair. They were wearing new clothes. Some of them were on foot, others were in bullock carts and on horses. The fair was full of joy. A little boy was also going to the fair along with his parents. So he was full of life and laughter. Come, child, come, called his parents as he lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shops that lined the way. So the child was very much fascinated, attracted by the toys shops which were lined there on the way. So he was just lagged behind. So his parents just called him by saying, come, child, come. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call. His eyes were still lingering on the receding toys. Means, though he was very obedient, he listened to his parents at once, but his eyes were still staring, were just looking at the toys. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him, he could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. Though he was very much known that if he is going to ask for anything, he knew very well that he will get the refusal. Means no, his parents won't allow him to buy those things. I want that toy, he pleaded. His father looked at him red-eyed. Red-eyed means very angrily. So when the boy just pleaded urge for a toy, at that time his father looked very angrily at him in his familiar tyrant's way, in a very strict way. His mother, melted by the free spirit of the day, was tender and giving him her finger to hold, said, look, child, what is before you? So his mother was really very tender and delicate heart, and she has a very delicate heart. So she told him to hold his finger, and she just wanted to just divert his mind. So she told that, look, what are the other things are there in the fair? It was a flowering mustard field, pale like melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even land. So it was a flowering mustard field. So right now we have just celebrated Baisakhi, and we all know we are very much fortunate to see the mustard field around a school also, that how the mustard field are just very yellow. It seems as the gold is melting. A group of dragonflies were bustling about on their gaudy purple wings, intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. So at that time the boy saw a group of dragonflies. They were just about to sit on the gaudy means very bright purple wings, intercepting means interfering The flight of a lone, lone means lonely, black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. So what he says that what he has seen that the group of dragonflies were just roaming on the gaudy flowers and they just wanted to suck the juice of the flowers. So they have just interfered the flight of a lonely black bee or a butterfly. The child followed them in the air with his gaze till one of them would still its wing and rest and he would try to catch it. So the boy just followed them in the air, okay, and he followed it till that butterfly just sits somewhere, okay, and he tried to catch it. This you also might have done, that when the butterfly fly, you might have just chased it and you try to catch it. In the same way, that boy also did the same thing. But it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air when he had almost caught it in his hands. So what happened? When he caught butterfly in his hand, it started flapping. Okay? And he just saw that how the butterfly was just fluttering and flapping. Then his mother gave a cautionary call. Come child, come. Come on to the footpath. So at that time, his mother has given a cautionary call. Cautionary means call with a safety in mind. By keeping the safety in mind, she called her child. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being however soon left behind, attracted by the little insects and worms along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. So he just ran towards his parents very happily and walked abreast of them for a while, being however soon left behind. So he was just walking with them, and very soon what he has just noticed that he was just lagged behind, though he was just abreast. Abreast means to walk with someone or next to somebody. So what he just noticed that he was just lagged behind because he was attracted by the little insects and worms, okay? And those insects and worms were just trying to teeming out. Teeming out means coming out in large number out of their holes of or out of their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. Come child, come, his parents called from the shade of a grove where he had seated themselves on the edge of a well. He ran towards them. So again his parents just called from the shade of a grove. Grove is a group of trees where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. He ran towards them.